But say a prayer, pray for the other one. At Christmas time, it's hard, but when you're having fun, there's a world outside your window, and it's a world of dread and fear. All the clanging chimes of doom. Well, tonight, thank God it's them instead of you.
Which way does Boy George go?
No, 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 hold on for a second.
Come on.
See you later. Take
care. See you later.
See you,
Simon.
See you later. See you, guys. Where is it? Right up. Boy, Simon! Hey, look this way.
You're trying to crash the rumours.
What?
I will,
good as well. What is this? Everybody's quite good. Bloody hell.
Had enough practice.
My next to Alf, or is it Paul Young next?
No, it was Paul Young first.
Alf next?
No, it wasn't Alf. That was Al.
Who was that?
George Michael.
God, it's Andy Camp. But then he is.
Look what you missed.
Tell me who the harmony is.
Not on that bit. There's another bit here that we'd like you to do as well, though.
There won't be snow in Africa this Christmas time. The greatest gift they'll get this year is life. Oh, when nothing ever grows, no rain or river flow, do they know it's Christmas time at all?
After that,
the Ethiopian fan appeal will be boosted by sales of a special pop record.
Oh, there you go.
Over 25 stars sang for nothing at today's recording session in London, and all the proceeds will go to famine relief.
When he saw the TV pictures from Ethiopia, Bob Geldof of the Boomtime Rats decided he had to do something, and he found his pop friends felt the same. So today, George Michael of Juan, Sting of the Police, Tony Hadley of Spandau Ballet, Bananarama, and a string of other British pop names got together free of charge to record a special Christmas song from which all the profits will go to Ethiopia.
The funny thing was, you know, you see all these guys individually, you know, very good-looking boys and girls, you know, and the perfectly coiffed hair and the clothes, and you see star, you know, written all over them. And then when they all got together, it just looked like a bunch of yobos in any old pub in the world, you know.
I suppose there is a moral reason for buying it, you know.
Any other good reason that might make number one for Christmas?
Any other good reason? Well, it just means it'll stop all these really trashy bands getting to number one. I mean, it'd be nice to have a record that sort of had some kind of sort of social significance, you know. I would say it was more socially political than political. I think that's more important. You know, caring about other people is really important. You know, and there isn't really that much charity in the world when you think about it. You know, and I know there are a lot of other people who aren't pop stars who do a lot more work for charity. So, you know, I don't want to stand here saying, oh, we're so wonderful. But if you do have an opportunity and you can use your position to influence people to sort of spend money on something like this, I think it is healthy, you know. Because, I mean, you know, we're so indulgent, aren't we, really?
This whole thing is a one-off, which is a pity. But it is an extraordinary operation that came together just because people wanted to do something. So I'm glad we did it.
It's Christmas time. There's no need.